All right, finally, it has arrived. Well, arrived in some way, shape, or form, but that doesn't matter. Let's take a look at the second to last Marvel film from phase one of the cinematic universe until the upcoming Avengers Infinity War in all of its glory. G to the S here. Today, I'm gonna be reviewing a movie that most people find to be a piece of crap, but many others like me find it to be entertaining as any action Marvel movie out there, if ever there was one, Iron Man 2. With the world now aware that he is Iron Man, billionaire inventor Tony Stark faces pressure from all sides to share his technology with the military. He is reluctant to divulge the secrets of his armored suit, fearing the information will fall into the wrong hands. With Pepper Potts, played by Gwyneth Paltrow, and Rhodey Rhodes, played by Don Cheadle, by his side, Tony must forge new alliances and confront a most powerful new enemy. Seems like a villain that everyone might know, but I won't spoil who he is in case you don't. Now, as always, since there were some immense bashings that are needed to be addressed within this movie, I gotta start with the negatives before I get into the positives, because that's how I roll. A lot of people were complaining about the fact that the dialogue is really rushed and seems to lose focus on what's going on. And I might have to agree with you on that note. The dialogue can be a little convoluted and confusing to the plot. And trust me, it happens a lot in this movie. There's no shame in that. It felt like they didn't take their time to divulge the story and plotline as people like you and me wanted it to be. And of course, the characters can be a little bit sidelined, except for Clark Gregg as Agent Coulson of S.H.I.E.L.D. yet again. He still has the guts to be intimidating. Even Samuel Jackson as Nick Fury. I mean, sure, he has a couple brief scenes, but still, he is awesome to watch on screen. But I'll save that for the positive side of things. But yeah, to sum things up, I can see where you guys are going with. The dialogue is rushed, and the characters can be in the background at times, and that's a bit jarring as heck, I'll admit. But at the same time, there are my only two main problems with this movie. On a positive note, the CGI, camera work, cinematography, and action sequences were still entertaining to watch. Jon Favreau still did excellent with the direction. Robert Downey Jr. still kills it as Tony Stark. The story was intriguing. I was invested in what's going on, and I was having a gosh darn blast watching this movie. And like I said, even though Nick Fury can have a couple quick scenes in this movie, he's still one of the most interesting characters within this universe. And that's enough to make me a happy Marvel fan that I am right now. Just keep in mind though, there is some content in this film that might not be appropriate for young kids. Like, there's this whole scene where the president of the US government, played by the late Gary Shandling, says the F-bomb twice, thankfully censored, right to Tony Stark's face about the fact that he should turn in the Iron Man suit to the US government. That was unexpected. I was like, okay, even though this movie's PG-13, good thing the developers decided to bleep them out as it to act as reality TV, it still can be a little bit edgy and too in your face, don't you think? But still, in the end, to shorten up this review, Iron Man 2 was an entertaining film to watch, but not one of the best Marvel films ever made. We are dealing with the Star-Spangled Man with a Plan next, so stay tuned. That will close off phase one soon. But in the meantime, I rate Iron Man 2 4 out of 5 stars. Not a perfect film by any means, but still not that terrible of a movie either. I still had fun watching it. It was good. So Iron Man 2, have you seen it? If you haven't, let me know in the comments what you thought about it. Is it good? Is it terrible? Answers down below, please. But if you like this video and you want to see some more, make sure that like button shines in your face. That'll totally help me out a ton. Also, share that video with your family and friends and favorite it. Also, as you saw at the beginning of this video, to show even more support, why not donate to my Patreon account? Links in the description below. That helps out a whole lot for both my channel as well as my review. But until then, I'll see you next time. Peace out.